वेलकम वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट इन फार्मास्यूटिकल वन प्रैक्टिकल माई सेल्फ दर्शना संदीप शिंदे एंड आवर टूडेज प्रैक्टिकल सेशन इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू द एरोमेटिक वाटर्स. इन दिस सेशन वी सी द थियरी रिगार्डिंग एंड प्रैक्टिकल्स रिगार्डिंग द एरोमेटिक वाटर्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी द theory regarding aromatic waters. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students should be able to understand, to develop intellectual skills, to understand the concept of solubility, to develop the motor skills, skill for weighing, measurement of volume for different aromatic waters, skill for clarification and filtration. All these skills should be developed in the student after watching this video. First of all, we see the theory regarding the aromatic waters. Aromatic waters are the clear aqueous solutions saturated with the volatile oils, that is rose oil, peppermint oil or other aromatic or volatile substances. Example of its camphor, their odor, taste are those of the drugs or volatile substance from which they are prepared. These are known as the aromatic waters. Aromatic waters are basically volatile, made from the volatile substances. Aromatic waters may be used for perfuming, flavoring or special purpose. Example of it of aromatic water is, first we see the camphor water. Camphor water has been used as the vehicle in the ophthalmic solutions owing to its ability to contribute the refreshing, stimulating effect to the preparations. These are the camphor waters. Mainly for the ophthalmic solutions use, and these are a refreshing ones, stimulating effect give to the preparation. And the next one example is Hamamelis water, or it is also known as the witch hazel. It is employed as a rub, perfume and as an astringent in various cosmetic preparations, particularly after shave lotions. In this it is used. These are all about the aromatic waters. These are introductory part. Then next we see the what are the aromatic waters. Aromatic waters are mainly of two types, simple aromatic waters and the concentrated aromatic waters. Then methods of aromatic water preparations are mainly three methods: distillation method, solution method and alternative solution methods. First of all, we see the distillation method. The distillation method involves the pressing of the coarsely ground odoriferous proportion of the plant or the drug from which aromatic water is to be prepared in a suitable still with the sufficient purified water. In this distillation method, we place the ground or a coarsely grounded or orifice portion of the plant or the drug into the suitable container, and in this we put the little bit of water. Most of the volume of water is then distilled, and then the excess of oil collected with the distillate rise to the top of the aqueous product and are removed. The distillate is collected at the top of the product because these distillate or with this product we are getting from the volatile substances, because they are in a volatile nature, so they are rise to the top of the aqueous product because they are light in weight. Volatile products are light in weight than the water. Then remaining aqueous solutions saturated with the volatile matter required clarification by the filtration. This one is the distillation assembly. In this this is the distillation flask. This is the flame. chamber. And this is a thermometer for measuring the temperature, and this one is the condenser. In this condenser, there is a two out water outlet. First one is a cooling water outlet, and this is the cooling water inlet. From this inlet, we have to put or pair the cool water in this condenser, and this is the water outlet. From this this tube, the fumes of the our product or fumes of this our distillate is when going from this chamber, these two water outlet inlet and outlet can cool these vapors, and these cooled vapors are collected into the distillate or a specific beaker. In this way, a distillation process can be carried out. Then next method is a solution method. Aromatic water is prepared by the intermediately shaking 2 ml of if liquid or 2 gram if a solid of the volatile substance with the 1000 ml of purified water in a suitable container for a period of 15 minutes. This is the solution method. In this simple one method, there are two solutions added and simple shaking is there. If the period of agitation, the mixture is set aside for the 12 hours or long to permit the excess of oil and the solid substance to be settled. Without further agitation, the mixture is passed through a wetted filter paper and purified water added as needed to be the bring to volume of the filtrate up to the prescribed quantity. In this way, solution method, in this in the solution method, there is a two solution should be added and agitated it and place it for the 12 hours or longer period, and if there is a need, there should be filtered out. Then third method is the alternative solution method. And this is the, by this method, the volatile oil or suitably comminuted aromatic solid is thoroughly incorporated with the 15 gram of the talc, and to this mixture is added 1000 ml of the purified water. The resulting slurry is thoroughly agitated several times for a period of 30 minutes and then filtered. This is the alternative solution method. In this this is also in this solutions are mixed together, but there is some talc like agents should be incorporated for proper mixing or absorbing the excess of oil. This one is the alternative solution method. This is the theory behind the aromatic water. And we nextly move towards the laboratory for the further experiments. Before entering to the laboratory, we have to know about the preparation of concentrated aromatic, how we are prepared the aromatic waters in a concentrated forms. These products are alcoholic non-aqueous preparation containing 2% of the volatile oils. They are 40 times stronger than the ordinary aromatic waters. Many volatile oils contain the aromatic part and non-aromatic part. The aromatic portion is much more suitable in a weak alcohol than a non-aromatic portion. Hence, when a solution of the oil in a 90% alcohol is diluted with the limited amount of water, the aromatic portion of oil remain in the soil will be non-aromatic portion is precipitated off or separating as a oily layer. Therefore, 50 grams of talc is added for the 1000 ml of the preparation, which act as a distributing agent. Talc, here the role of the talc is a distributing agent and will absorb the non-aromatic part. The solution is agitated and set aside for a few hours and then filtrated. Storage conditions for the concentrated aromatic water are: aromatic waters deteriorate with the time. This one is the fact we should be kept in the mind. It should be made in a small quantities and protected from the intense light, excessive heat, store in a airtight and light resistance container. Okay, this is the how we made the preparation of concentrated aromatic water. Then next we move to the laboratory, and there we see the our experiment numbers.
Welcome dear student in a pharmaceutics first laboratory. In this session we cover experiment number 7. Title of our experiment is to prepare, evaluate and submit 100 ml of concentrated dill water IP by simple solution method. In this method we also use the simple method for the preparation of. Apparatus required for to prepare the concentrated dill water are dill oil, then talcum powder, alcohol, 90% alcohol, and in a apparatus session or in apparatus measuring cylinder, beaker, then filtrating assembly, though the product is containing the talc, that's why we required a filtrating assembly, funnel, trifold stand, this one is a pipette, and this one is a 10 ml small measuring cylinders.
Being familiar with the apparatus and chemicals, we let us move towards the formulation table. How to prepare the formulation table for the preparation of concentrated dill water? This formulation table consists of first ingredients, then quantity given in a IP, that is for 1000 ml, then quantity taken can be calculated by the factors multiplied by quantity given. Here we calculate the factor can be calculated by quantity required, that is our quantity required is 100 ml, and quantity given, which is given in our formula, which is mentioned in the Indian pharmacopoeia, that is for 1000 ml. So we get 100 upon 1000, we get our factor is 0.1, and that factor from is we multiplied our quantity given, that means for an example dill oil 20 ml, we multiplied 20 into 0.1, then we get the quantity taken for 100 ml is 2 ml. In this way we for the same can procedure do for the alcohol we required for 1000 ml 600 ml, and we multiplied 600 to the 0.1, and then we get the quantity for the 100 ml, that is the 60 ml. Then purified talc, which is required 1000 ml, that is 50 gram. Then we multiply 50 into 0.1, we get the 5 gram, that is the quantity for the 100 ml. And purified water, that is QS2, 1000 ml. And for 100 ml, that is QS2, 100 ml. We see the uses of the our ingredient. Dill oil is used as a carminative. Alcohol is used as a co-solvent. Purified talc, which is as an adsorber. And purified water as a wake.
Let's move towards the stepwise procedure for the concentrated dill water. For the preparation of dill water, first we have to take our required quantity of dill water, that is 2 ml, which is required for 100 ml of concentrated dill water preparation. After taking required quantity of dill water, we have to take the 60 ml of our alcohol. This is the 50 ml. We'll take more 10 ml of alcohol. This will be more quantity. We adjust the volume of our alcohol. And this is totally 60 ml of alcohol. Stir vigorously.
with the help of the stirrer. After that, we add, this is the 5 gram of the purified talc, which already measured, and this one is added toward this preparation. Here, this talc is a serve as a, or it is a play and roll as a adsorbent. It adsorbs the terpenes which are present in the dill oil. That's why we added this talcum powder or purified talc powder, not talcum powder. So mix thoroughly. After 30 minutes, this talcum powder is properly mixed with dill water and alcohol solution. After that, take a filter paper, fold it, and place in a funnel. And this one is a filtering assembly ready, filter, tripod stand and beaker. Then pour this solution into it. In this way, our total preparation is filtered out. See, this is our final preparation, which one is clear in appearance. Then fill this clear solution into final container. We fill the container and we pour our concentrated dill water solution into this final container. We see the observation and evaluation here. This table contains the name of the preparation. Our name of preparation is concentrated dill water IP. Then test, we have required to perform the test for evaluation purpose. That test has a description, color, volume and odor. Let's see one by one. Description is clear. Our preparation's description is clear one. That's why we confirm that test. Then color, our preparation has a colorless, that's how we also confirm this test. After that, volume of our preparation is 100 ml, that's why this test also we confirm. And finally, the odor. Then this contains a concentrated dill water, so dill water has an aromatic, so its odor is aromatic. And finally, we also confirm this test. After observation table and evaluation table, we see the labeling of our formulation. For the labeling purpose, we have to prepare the label in this way, that it should be contained the name of our preparation, that is concentrated dill water IP, quantity of our preparation, that is 100 ml. Then each 100 ml content or each 10 ml content, or we should be mentioned each 1 ml content. Here I mentioned each 100 ml content, that is dill water 2 ml. Alcohol 90%, which is 60 ml. Purified water, that is US 200 ml. In the while preparing this solution, we use the talcum powder as an adsorbent, but here in the formula, there is no need to mention the name of the talcum powder. Then dose of our preparation is 0.3 to 1 ml. Then category A as a flavoring agent and as a carbonative. Then storage, though it has a volatile weight, that's why it should be stored in a airtight container. Then manufacturing license number, then manufacturing batch number, manufacturing date of expiry or expiry date, and then maximum retail price. And then last, the name of our manufacturer, that should be mentioned at the bottom of the label. In this way, we prepared the label. Here, a specimen copy. We already prepared here, and we stick this specimen copy or this copy of our label, that is should be
after seeing how to evaluate the observation table for the concentrated dill water and labeling of dill water, we move towards the result. Result should be written as, we prepared the 100 ml of concentrated dill water, that's why 100 ml of concentrated dill water IP preparation is submitted in airtight container away from light with the neat label. In this way we return the result. After that, some questions are on this experiment. The first one is, what are the carbonatives? In this session we see the different questions associated with the our concern experiment. Our experiment is the preparation of concentration of dill water. In the dill water is a nature is a carbonative, that's why we see the different questions and answers. What are the carbonatives? Carbonatives are the drugs which are used to expel the gases from the GIT and increase the peristalsic movement of our intestine. Then give the second question is give the name of the official preparation of concentrated dill water. That is a preparation which contain the concentrated dill water. That is, example of it is gripe water, which is available in the market. Then state the functions of the talc in the preparation of the dill water. The use of the talc is as an adsorbent. The talc adsorbs the turpentine or terpenes of a volatile oil which are present in the dill oil, and that's why we use the talc as a adsorbent. Then next one is the, why should dill water should be stored in an airtightly closed container? That is, dill water is a volatile in nature, that's why it should be stored in a tightly closed containers. Then state the concentration of the volatile oil in the concern aromatic water. That means, what amount of concentration of the volatile oil should be present in the preparation. That is, the volatile part is a carbon, and which is present not less than 45% weight by weight and not more than 63% weight by weight of the carbon as a volatile content. Then next one is, a give biological source of a dill and name the volatile part of the dill oil and what's its concentration. We see the concentration is of not less than 45% and not more than 63%. Biological source, dill consists of a dried ripe fruits of the Anethum gravellonus Linn family is Amyloferae. These are the questions which are ask on this experiment. Thank you very much for attending my practical session.